good? It's the Fly Haitian Kid, DJ Cash, rocking out with Caribbean Focus TV. Stay focused, all right?
Atlanta, welcome to another episode of Caribbean Focus TV. Yeah, this is your girl, Cherry Garden. And thanks for tuning in to another episode. You know we have something fresh, something new, something exciting in store for you today. Guys, in case you didn't know, we are all over social media. So Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, make sure you look up Caribbean Focus TV. Everything is just Caribbean Focus TV. And if you have anything that you'd like to send to us, communicate with us, sponsor the show, let us know about any events that you have going on, let us know about your business. Look, we are here for you. So you email us, all right? CaribbeanFocusTV@gmail.com. That's our email address. And if you've missed any of our past episodes, and sometimes, because it's a 30-minute segment, we can't fit everything that we have on the show. So you know what you got to do. You got to go to the website, CaribbeanFocus.tv, all right? www.CaribbeanFocus.tv. Now, guys, we have a very spicy, exciting, multicultural show for you today. We're going to educate you. We're going to get you dancing. We're going to get that blood pumping, the party flowing, you know, since Cherry got in a party, y'all, so you know, it's all about getting the blood flowing and the energy going. So, you know what? With no further ado, I want you guys to go ahead and get up out your seats and really start moving your hips to this next musical interlude video that we have coming up for you. Up next, we actually have Nore, N-O-R-E, Oye Mi Canto. Guys, go ahead, start dancing, enjoy, and make sure you keep it locked. Stay focused.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Leah Culver with Caribbean Focus TV. Stay focused.
If you're proud to be Latino right now, stand up. Grab a cup, scrub a cup, scrub. SBK.
Guest host that I'm excited to bring to you today. She is, her trademark name is being just hyper, what's it called? Hyper, oh my goodness, see,
I'm multi-hypernet.
Thank you. Multi-hypernet. Okay, and she'll explain to you what that word is, but I'm bringing to you right now the one and only Lady Lalabella, AKA Leanne Fairweather, AKA the Black Queen.
Oh my goodness, I'm so humbled by that awesome introduction. Thank you so much, Cherry Garden.
Really and truly, it's an honor to be here with you today. I've heard great things about Caribbean Focus TV, and I'm just happy to be here as a Caribbean descendant myself.
Man, it's great to have you. Thanks. Well, you know what? Tell us a little bit about yourself, because the viewers out here are wondering, okay, who's this Lady Lalabella girl?
Who am I? Okay. I can go ahead and tell you that I'm of Jamaican heritage, born right here in Atlanta, Georgia. But my parents are Jamaican, and of course, I'd like to share that culture and pretty much share it in any way that I can. I'm very expressive. I love Jamaican food, Jamaican music, and of course, I attend the local events, as we've both been able to do great press for it.
That's right, that's right. So you said you're multi-hyphenate, right? Did I say it
multi-hyphenate.
Multi-hyphenate, oh
yeah.
Gosh.
It's the thing about a hyphen, it's like the dash in between words. It's how you're able to give more than one title to someone. So someone can be an artist, a musician, as well as even a teacher. Sometimes one title does not control it all. So you're able to have more than one name for one person.
So what makes you multi-hyphenate?
I'm able to speak three languages. I speak Spanish, Portuguese, and a little bit of French. Mm. I also like to be able to dance and express my Jamaican culture and my love for the Caribbean. Mm-hmm. I draw, I'm an illustrator, and I do blogging as a social media manager.
Wow, and tell us about your blog. That way we can look at, check it out.
Oh, thank you so much. My blog is www.momentsofablackqueen.com, and it just pretty much chronicles all of the adventures that I have here in Atlanta. I often go to New York as well, making a trip to Miami soon for Carnival. So it's just some great things that are going on. You're gonna definitely wanna keep up with my advances.
Fantastic. Now, I don't know if Lady Lalabella here mentioned that she's also a Spanish teacher, but with that aspect, that is actually why we have her here on the show with us today.
Indeed.
Tell us a little bit about how special this month of September is.
Well, something that a lot of people don't know is that in 1968, President Lyndon Johnson inaugurated the wonderful month of Hispanic Heritage Month, also known as Latin American Heritage Month. Now, this month was started from September 15th to October 15th to celebrate all of the Latin and Caribbean countries of Latin heritage throughout the entire month. Something that a lot of people don't know is that in 1988, Ronald Reagan extended it for something to happen every year. So this is a great celebration that we're able to have and something that I think needs a lot more exposure.
Wow, wow. Okay, and then tell us a little bit about Latin culture in the Caribbean.
Well, I think that it all flushes in, because as Caribbean people, all of we is one. So you have to look at it in a spectrum. All of us have different flavors, have different complexions, have different traditions. However, when we come together, we're able to see the same similarities in the colors of our flags, mm-hmm. and also our heritage and the weather that we have, the very mm-hmm. tropical weather, as well as the way that we dance and enjoy ourselves and like to have fun.
Definitely.
So if you think about those things and consider it, we all are pretty much of the same Caribbean diaspora.
Like a microcosm. Fantastic. All right, guys, we're gonna take a quick break. Make sure you keep it locked and stay focused.
Yeah, check it out, man. It's your boy Akon, and you got it locked right here to Caribbean Focus TV. All right, stay focused, baby. Yeah.
Welcome back, CFTV viewers. So I can't just make it just a whole big party show, you know, because Caribbean Focus TV focuses on giving you a well-balanced diet, a well-balanced meal. So we can bring you that news, that culture, that entertainment, and part of all of that is education. So being that it's Latin American or Hispanic Heritage Month, I want to just let everybody know that, mind you, 495 million people in the world speak Spanish, you know. Let that sink in. Mm-hmm. It, according to the U.S. Census for Spanish speakers, it's the number three, it's the third most common language in the entire world. It's the second most common language spoken in the United States, apart from English. Mm-hmm. And out of 38 million West Indians, 62% speak Spanish. That's
a lot. Did you know that?
I didn't know it was such large numbers. I knew it was, of course, it's the second most prominent language in the U.S.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Wow. Well, share with us a little bit more about the Heritage Month.
Well, something very interesting about just the Caribbean in general is that not a lot of people realize that people from Cuba, from the Puerto Rico, from Panama, from Dominican Republic, all are of Hispanic heritage and they speak Spanish. People aren't aware that that is also a part of the Caribbean. They're just aware of it being a part of Latin America. Mm. So I think that people of Caribbean heritage can learn a thing or two from the Spanish-speaking islands.
Definitely, definitely. So tell us a little bit more about how much Spanish, how much
impact.
Yes, there we go. That's the word. See, okay. Getting tongue twisted today.
You're doing a great job. Just as far as why Spanish matters, Spanish speaks too. So it's a completely different language. I know that a lot of people aren't as open to learning a foreign language, but if we go across the world into Europe, into Africa, mm-hmm. most people speak 3 or 4 languages. So I think Americans, as well as Caribbeans, could definitely pick up Spanish as an extra language. Something important is that Spanish is the official language of 22 countries around the world. Spanish is the second largest native language spoken in the entire globe. Spanish is the second most used for international communication, so it's definitely number one in business. Spanish is the third most used language on the internet. So imagine going on the internet one day and it's completely in Spanish. How would you be able to understand?
Wow. Yeah, well, I'm glad I took Spanish in high school and college.
That's we could all take a class or two to brush up, go abroad, something to consider.
This is true. So being that this is Caribbean Focus TV, guys, in the Caribbean, I think Lady Lalabella, the Black Queen, mentioned the countries of Hispanic culture in mm-hmm. the Caribbean, that being Panama, Dominican Republic.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm sorry, did I just say Haiti? Cuba.
Hispaniola.
Right. See, the neighbors. Because, you know, our last episode was just about the dynamic between the Dominican Republic and Haiti.
Yes,
so, guys,
if
you missed that, yeah, I'm glad. If you missed that, definitely backtrack on our website and check that out. Because Corey, my wonderful co-host, she killed that wonderful panel. Like, they really communicated. They poured it out as to what the dynamics were. So, I mean, shameless plug. I have to shout out to Corey, Renee, and her panel with Hero. Okay, but yes, back to the Hispanic culture. So, and then one more country I'm missing, what? Panama, right?
Panama, but Panama is actually not an island. It's a part of the South America. It's really close to the Caribbean, mm-hmm. and people of Caribbean heritage, well, people from Panamanian heritage, mm-hmm. Afro-Panamanians are comprised of descendants of slaves and immigrants from Trinidad, Martinique, Guadeloupe, Barbados, and, a lot of people don't know this, Jamaica.
Yeah.
These are the people that came over to help build the Panama Canal. And because of that, they intermingled with the natives and were able to create a whole new race and ethnicity of individuals with a lot of Caribbean features.
Fantastic. All right, guys. So, we just gave you a whole lot of information.
Panama, Dominican Republic, Cuba, and
Puerto Rico! Big up to
Boricua.
The Boricua! Oh, yeah!
Absolutely, girl.
Guys, go ahead and keep it focused, keep it locked. We're going to take a quick break. Stay focused.
Ready? Yo, what's up, everybody? This is Walshy Fire, and you're watching Caribbean Focus TV. Stay focused.
Welcome back, CFT viewers. You're still hanging here with your girl, Cherry Garden, on Caribbean Focus TV. And I have a wonderful co-host on set today, Leanne Fairweather, the one and only Lady Lalabella, also known as the Black Queen. And we're here chopping it up about Hispanic Heritage Month.
Indeed.
Now, because CFTV also brings you staple information like the news, there are quite a few news issues, or should I say issues in the Hispanic Caribbean community that are prevalent right now. So, Ms. Fairweather, let's dialogue a little bit about what's going on in the Hispanic Caribbean community. So we already touched on Haiti and Dominican Republic and their interactions, right?
Absolutely.
And how does that make you feel, that particular news item?
I do think it's something that's currently going on here in the United States as well.
Hmm.
Just as far as people not being able to freely be able to express themselves because of where they were born. A lot of Mexicans aren't able to come here and live properly because maybe they came over here in an inappropriate fashion or format. And some people might feel differently that they don't belong here. Mm. But for more than one reason, we have to be open to people of Mexican descent coming here to the United States, just as much as people of Dominican heritage need to be open to Haiti being right next to them. Mm. And also that people of Haitian descent did grow up and were born in Dominican Republic.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of times countries are really sensitive about their
borders.
Mm-hmm. Yes, their homeland security and stuff like that. Like, for instance, let's jump to the Puerto Rico, jump islands here. Puerto Rico, how many of you think that Puerto Rico is a state in the United States? Show of hands. I wish I could see your hands. But no, apparently it is not a state. We have a big correction for you.
It's actually a territory.
Correct.
A lot of people don't know that Puerto Ricans are still fighting for statehood. They want to have the same rights that a lot of Americans have. And because they're just a territory, are falling short. And their economy is not in the best shape either.
Oh, wow. So what do you think should be done? Do you think that people need to help raise awareness for
statehood
for Puerto Rico?
I think that definitely helped them with their economy. Mm-hmm. They're practically our neighbors, and they are one of our territories. So if we could funnel some tourism there, maybe put more commercials on for promoting their tourism. It's a beautiful island. Mm-hmm. I think that people would be more open to opening it up as an actual state for the United States.
And it's beneficial because you don't need, you can travel there on a U.S. passport.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
Or do you not need a passport?
You don't need a passport at all.
You can use your driver's license.
Absolutely.
So guys, yeah, make sure you check out Puerto Rico for your next
vacation.
And just really quick, we want to touch on the U.S. Embassy in Havana. So Cuba via John Kerry. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, John Kerry, of course, he's been doing his best to pretty much open the diplomacy for us to be able to travel to Cuba one day. It'd be nice to think that Americans can go over there and be able to enjoy the beautiful island of Cuba, as well as for them to be able to come over here in a just way, in a great fashion, and be able to get rights from the embassy here in the United States. Mm-hmm. So opening those doors, I think, is a great opportunity. I think that it was right on time, something that I think was appropriate for Barack Obama to implement as well. Mm-hmm. And I think it's going to open up the doors for a lot of other Spanish speakers to come to the United States.
Fantastic. Now, guys, we're going to take a quick break. Make sure that you keep it locked because we have a very fun part of the show coming up. We're going to get you back out of your seats, get you moving and grooving. Guys, make sure you keep it locked and stay focused.
Yo, let me tell you so. Tanso back, come on, I chuck it on you. You must tanso back and them a bun up them mouth. Them a fi tanso back and focus on this. We not focus like no locust. This is original. When me say don't come focus or joke us. You understand me? No, let me tell you something. Let me say, stay focused. Sure. We always have to stay focused because what? This TV program is about focusing. Focus. Bless. Rojo, Professor not say that.
Valió la pena.
Woo! Oh my goodness.
That was so much fun.
I loved it. I mean,
great energy.
I love Latin dancing. Like, I mean, I loved Caribbean dancing too, you know, but so the Latin dancing is so elegant, keeps you moving.
Definitely gets the blood flowing, honey.
Yes, and it's all in the hips.
It's great for the heart.
Well, guys, we're coming to a close of another episode of Caribbean Focus TV. I do want to mention that Lady Lalabella, she is a blogger, and she wanted to touch on the hashtags a little bit. What did you want the viewers to know about with the hashtag? What can we do?
Well, here at Caribbean Focus TV, I do understand that you guys are big on social media, so I thought it would be very appropriate to have a Caribbean Focus hashtag to be associated with Latin American Heritage Month.
Okay.
I think it's going to get the conversation started, get people talking about their own heritage and what makes them proud to be Caribbean.
Wow, so you guys hear that? Definitely type it or tag us in any pictures, any little tidbits, captions that you want to drop. Hashtag, what do you
want? Caribbean Focus.
Okay, fantastic. Hashtag Caribbean Focus.
Absolutely.
And make sure you check out Lady Lalabella's Moments of a Black Queen.
Indeed. Thank you so much for the plug.
My pleasure, my pleasure. We just want to shout out also some of the Latin American countries are celebrating Independence Day.
Yes. September.
Yes, that is definitely huge. Is there any correlation with that as to why?
Absolutely. It just seems like it's the perfect time.
Fantastic, fantastic. So off the top of your head, which countries do you know that are celebrating independence?
Mexico.
Okay.
Costa Rica.
Nicaragua.
And
let me see. What are we missing? We're missing Honduras, Guatemala, El Salvador.
It's getting good. It's getting good.
Yes. We got Costa Rica and Chile as well.
So I definitely think that even the countries in the Caribbean should go out and celebrate with their neighbors.
Definitely. So guys, this is a big month for Latin American heritage. Yes. Make sure that you keep it locked to Caribbean Focus TV because we might just have Miss Lady Lalabella on again for
Excelente.
A few more episodes.
Yay.
Kind of bringing little snippets. So if you like what you see, make sure you tune back in to see what more hip movements and education that our Spanish teacher / blogger / dancer / multi-hyphenate.
It's all about the Caribbean flavor.
Fantastic. You know what I'm saying about Jamaicans? Always have many jobs, right?
Mm-hmm.
She is Jamaican.
Yeah, man.
Fantastic, guys. Well, thank you so much for coming on this show.
I really appreciate it. Shout out to Corey as well. She's a great co-host.
We heart you. Heart. Now, guys, just in, you know, you had picked out the first video, which was Oye Me Canto. What was one thing that you really liked about that video?
I really liked the fact that they had all of the flags being shown and exhibited. I think that a part of Caribbean pride is being able to show all the different colors and the diversity of the islands.
Fantastic. And guys, we have an awesome video coming up that we're going to go ahead and close the show with. Mm-hmm. It is Shakira, which is one of my favorite artists.
The hips don't lie.
Oh, see, I told you it's all about the hips, as you saw today. Guys, make sure that you log on to our social media, Caribbean Focus TV on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Make sure you log on to our website if you missed any of our episodes, CaribbeanFocus.tv. Yes, that's it, www.caribbeanfocus.tv. And if you'd like to sponsor the show, if you'd like to let us know about any events that you need the Caribbean community to know about, make sure you email us at caribbeanfocustv@gmail.com. We want to hear from you because we are a representative of you. We reflect and we're here to join and unite the Caribbean community.
Absolutely.
So definitely communicate with us as well.
September 15th through October 15th, make sure you use the hashtag Caribbean Focus to get your best views on the Caribbean Focus TV website.
And we'll make sure to repost it and shout you out. Guys,
thanks everyone.
Enjoy the rest of the day.
Hey, it's your girl, Corey Renee, and I wanted to tell you about the 24th anniversary and 2015 Scholarship Awards Banquet hosted by the Guyana Association of Georgia Incorporated. Saturday, September 26th at the Georgia Piedmont Technical College Conference Center, 495 North Indian Creek Drive, Clarkston, Georgia, 30021. Cocktails at 6 o'clock, dinners at 7 o'clock, music by DJ Chica. Call 770-507-4831 or www.gaog.org.
Mission to unite, knowing of all our struggles. the sky.